Hello everyone, I am Jaya Madan from Chitkara University. By this video, I will be telling you how to extract the data from any graphical image by webplotdigitizer. You will be needing this extraction of data for some calibration purpose or authentication of your calibration simulation setup. So, in order to validate your simulation setup, most of the time we need to authenticate our simulation setup by some experimental data. So, if you have some experimental data and you want to extract that, then you can use this tool. So, this tool is an open source and it was developed by Ankit. And to get this tool, you can just simply go to this website and then download the same. So the moment you will download, you will get this shortcut, and the moment you will open this, you will get this window. So first of all, you will be loading the image by going to the file and then load image. Then you can choose the file, basically the image which you want to extract. So let's say I want to extract this image. So this is a normal 2D XY plot. And if you want to extract the data from the bar plot or the polar diagram, you can choose the corresponding option. And then first of all, you will be aligning the axis. So first of all, you will be choosing the X1 minimum and then the X2, that is the X max. If you want to relocate the point, you can use the up and down arrow, the left and right arrow key, to adjust your points, and then the y1, that is the minimum value of y, and then the y maximum, that is y2. So these are the points, these are the axes which you have selected. So you have calibrated the axis. Now you will complete. So the x minimum was 0, the maximum x value is 1.6, and the y minimum is 1e minus 17, and y maximum is 1e minus 5. But remember, this is the logarithmic scale on the y-axis, so I'll choose this log scale. Now if you want to extract the data of, say, the blue one and the red one and the black one, then there are three data sheets you will be needing. So you can go to data sets, add data sets, and you need three data sheets. So you'll choose three. So add multiple. This default data sheet you can delete. So now you have three data sets. Data set one, let's say we'll be using it for this SI, that is in black. Data set two, you will be using it for GE, that is in green color, red color. The data set three, you will be using for this GE, that is in blue color. So let's start with the silicon, that is SI, shown in black color. So the data extraction can be done by two methods. First of all, you can extract the data manually, that is manual extraction. Second, you can use the automatic extraction method. So let's start with the manual extraction method. For that, you will be choosing this add point. You can choose the points wherever you want to have your data. I am doing it randomly with high speed, but if you need more accuracy, then you can choose more number of points. Obviously, the higher the number of points you choose, the more accurate the results you will get. So this is the manual extraction method. So if I want to see the data, I can go to view data. So these are the points of x and y axis which I have chosen. I can download the CSV file and replot it on my Excel, and then I can verify the same. So let's first of all do the automatic extraction method, and then we'll cross verify the data. So I have done for the SI, that is shown in black. Let's do it for the red one, that is in GE, that is the data of GE. So I'll be showing it by the automatic extraction method. First of all, I'll be using this pen. So highlight the red area by this pen like this. And then after that you will be choosing this color, color picker, and then the red color. So done. So if you run this, you can see that there are large number of points it has taken. If you want to decrease the points, then you can increase this delta x and delta y. The accuracy will be less, but you can compromise the number of points with these delta x and delta y. Let's say we take it to be 30, and then again run. These are the optimum number of points which we can deal with. So again, you can see the data. Go to view data. These are the points which are extracted. So now I can download the CSV file. Let's say I save it here. Now you can go to the folder and then open it with Excel. So the moment I open, so the moment I open this folder, I'll get this data. So if I replot it and then I verify, I'll see the same plot which was shown in the red color, which I need to extract. You can verify this. This is the same data, starting from approximately 1E-17 to this point, that is 1E-4 around. So you can see this is the same data, 1E-17 to 1E-4. So this is the way you can extract the data from the experimental work for your calibration purpose. So you can increase this delta x, delta y. You can have some data sets. Furthermore, you can save the project, like save project, the name which you want for your project, and then download project file. So it will save the entire project with all the data sets. So in future, if you need the data again, then you can use the same. If I say clock, yes. And then if I want to reopen the project, then you can load the project like this, and you will get entirely the same project with the same data sets. So I thank you all for watching this video, and please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel.